Yeah, we define dipole moment like this. Again, we need to do many problem on this one, on this particular one. Wait a second. Now, again, while doing this integration, you have to be careful. We have done integration for electric field, am I right? R cap by R square. There, what we have done very first problem in Griffiths, we converted that variable vector into unit vector, and then we have done the integration. Okay, remember, if you are getting into any integral, write this r prime vector in terms of Cartesian coordinate, so that throughout the integral your x cap, y cap, z cap will be constant. You can take those things one side and you can do the integral. Okay, now here you need some coordinate geometry to handle continuous charge distribution problem again. Okay, on this one again. So now let me comment on this one. We have seen that so total potential V mono plus V dipole plus V quadrupole, like that, am I right? We had like this. This was 1 by R, this had 1 by R square, this had 1 by R cube, and so on, am I right? Now when you see the charge configuration from the large distance from the origin, so first term is dominant one, obviously, isn't it? When you see the configuration, so at a large distance or any distance, first term is the dominant one, am I right? Because 1 by R, you have 1 by R. So, so later R term will be 1 by R square, 1 by R cube, like that, okay? Now usually, the lowest non-zero term in the expansion provides the approximate potential at large distance, okay? They are designing lot of question on this one. So sometimes monopole term is zero, sometimes total charge may be zero, remember. If total charge is zero, this is zero, isn't it? If total charge is zero, so this monopole moment is zero, total charge, isn't it? So now if total charge is zero, this part is zero, then what is the dominant term? 1 by R square term, R 1 by R cube, 1 by R raised to 4, they are less dominant. Is that okay? Can you write one sentence? Because questions are designed on this basis, okay? That means they are asking at very large distance, how potential proportional to? You have to come to the conclusion by observing monopole moment, dipole moment, quadrupole moment, so which is zero. Is that okay? Suppose if monopole as well as dipole moment terms are zero, then what is the dominant one? Quadrupole moment, it is proportional to 1 by R cube, and electric field proportional to 1 by R to 4. Okay, derivative, I mean, so 1 by R raised to 4, is that okay? Yeah, that's how they, related, is that okay? They may ask question, okay? So that's why, can you write this sentence? The lowest non-zero term in the expansion, the lowest non-zero term in the expansion provides the approximate potential, provides the approximate potential for large R. Approximate potential, not for, at large R, at large R, normal R, at large R. Okay, we have italica here, isn't it? And successive term tells us how to improve approximation. If greater precision is required, just read out that one after the class, okay? Read out that one. If greater precision is required, obviously. But in exam, they will design the question in such a way that how potential proportional to for a given configuration. Now you have to judge by seeing that one, whether first you have to see whether monopole term is zero or not. If monopole term is non-zero, you can say at very large R, potential proportional to 1 by R. If monopole term is zero, you have to go for dipole term. dipole moment. Okay, if dipole moment is non-zero, if monopole moment is zero, if dipole moment is non-zero, what is the dominant term? 1 by r square. That's why you can say potential proportional to 1 by r square at very large r. At very large r, you can neglect higher part. Again, don't neglect this one also. In any approximation, keep a functionality. Then you have to write potential proportional to 1 by r square. If monopole term is 0, dipole term is non-zero. If these two are 0, okay, if these two are 0, then you have to go for this one. If these two are 0, wait a second, there was one question in exam. That was not doable that easily. If these two are 0, you can't say potential proportional to 1 by r cube. Why? Unless you show that this is also non-zero. Isn't it? They asked that question. These two were 0 and answer was 1 by r raised to 4. Now this is very difficult to evaluate. Again, he has given couple of problems. It's given couple of problems, but not that easily doable. Okay, you have to skip that kind of question. Obviously, you will have a choice in exam hall. No need to worry. Okay, you will have a choice in exam hall. Again, the topper is the one who avoided this kind of question. Remember, yeah, yeah. I tried in lot of ways. Again, there are no other ways of having any trick here. Okay. Again, it's you have to start from the beginning. Total charge is 0, dipole moment is also 0. If quadrupole moment is also 0, then again, you have to go for next higher one. Am I right? Again, my question is, unless you find next higher one, how do you say it is 1 by r raised to 4? Is that okay? In that question, their answer was 1 by r raised to 4. Now, even in this book, we don't have how to find octupole moment. Maybe he might have given at the end of the chapter. Okay. So he will put stars for his problem. I think in this book, he will put a dot or exclamatory mark in this book, electrodynamics. Okay. Yeah. Anyway, we shall try to expand. Again, in gate exam, very logical question, very easily doable, but you have to see the question in particular way. Are you getting the idea? It's all about approximation. So now next one is, so let me again go to this dipole moment part. Okay, let me again go to this dipole moment part. Let me have some idea. Yeah, this approximation. Wait a second. So total potential, we divided it into V monopole moment plus V dipole plus V quadrupole plus and so on. Am I right? Like that. So this monopole moment, it was proportional to 1 by r. Dipole moment 1 by r cube, r square. Quadrupole moment 1 by r raised to cube. So like that. Octupole moment 1 by r raised to 4. Am I right? If suppose total charge is 0 in the system, then what is this one? 0. There is no monopole moment. Is that okay? Suppose if total charge is non-zero, suppose if you are at very large distance, look at here, these are very less dominant. This is the most dominant. At very large distance, if total charge is non-zero, your potential varies like 1 by r from the origin. Okay, let me talk about this one. Lot of geometrical factor involved. You need to solve problem to understand completely. Okay, wait a second. If Q is non-zero, if total charge is non-zero, okay, then potential proportional to 1 by r for large r. Is that okay? If Q total is equal to 0, but dipole moment is non-zero. Is that okay? Then this term exists. This term will be 0. Isn't it? So then what would happen? Potential proportional to 1 by r square for large r. Better write down. isn't it? Isn't it? Because this part is 0. Now 1 by r square, 1 by r cube and so on, at very large r, you can neglect all higher part. That is the dominant term actually. So next one, if q total is equal to 0 and p also equal to 0, okay? Now next term, we haven't defined quadrupole moment, am I right? Yeah, let me write, but V quadrupole non-zero, then potential approximately 1 by r cube for large. Yeah, sometimes I will get angry and I wanted to show that question wrong. I tried that quadrupole we can show 0, but octopole where it's difficult. Yeah, isn't it? They shouldn't have asked that kind of question. Somewhere copied. Anyway, there will be very less question in entire exam, one or two question like that. You should not be worried with that one. Be practical, okay? Is that okay? Again, I was talking about some problem, okay? Some particular problem from CSA. Yeah? So again, so if suppose quadrupole moment is also 0, starting from the beginning, then obviously it is proportional to 1 by r raised to 4. Yeah, but you have to say that octopole moment is non-zero. Is that okay? Quadrupole moment is 0, octopole moment is non-zero. Okay, then only that can happen, okay? Yeah, anyway, we shall restrict our discussion within this one. Yeah, speak out. Yeah, you have plus q and minus q, you have dipole moment. Total charge is 0. Why are you thinking like that? Now, what would happen here is, I have plus q, minus q. Plus q, minus q, look at here. Now net charge is also 0. Now dipole moment is also 0. That can happen. Even though they are vector at separated by some distance, they will get cancelled, their effect. Is that okay? We can show that one. Then dipole, total charge is also 0. Dipole moment is also 0. Then this is a quadrupole configuration that I have drawn very earlier. Quadrupole moment is non-zero. Is that okay? Yeah. Again, we are restricting ourselves up to dipole moment, okay? Now, let me just discuss something about dipole moment, am I right? So we define dipole moment like, for a point charge distribution, a qi into ri prime vector, am I right? In the integral format, we have rho of r prime d tau prime into r vector prime, r prime vector, am I right? So this was dq, and location of dq is r prime from the origin. So similarly, qi, location of that one is ri prime from the origin, and summation over I, that will be dipole moment, okay? Now let me take pure dipole in space, pure physical dipole. We call this one as physical dipole. Again, wait a second, I should not have used the word pure. Pure dipole is different, physical dipole is different. Let me take one physical dipole, okay? Let me talk about that one. This is also a question. Physical dipole means it is very well separated, okay? Pure dipole means it's very, charges should be very close to each other, okay? Let me talk about that one, okay? What is pure dipole, perfect dipole, physical dipole, ideal dipole, like that, okay? Whatever. So now let me take one physical dipole. I have plus q charge here, minus q charge here in space. What is the dipole moment you already know? That is minus to plus, am I right? Wait a second, we shall define in this way. We shall define in this way. Let me choose origin. You can choose origin anywhere. Am I right? Now, what is this one? Let me just write this one as r prime plus. What is this one? R prime minus. Is that okay? Now, let me define dipole moment. So, plus q into r prime plus. Plus q into location of plus q charge. Position vector of location of plus q charge. Am I right? That's how this defined. So, plus minus q into r minus prime vector. Am I right? So, q outside r plus prime minus r minus prime. What is r plus prime minus r minus prime? There's a vector from minus q to plus q according to vector addition. Am I right? R plus prime minus r minus prime. R minus r minus prime is this one. This one plus this one should be equal to this one. Is that okay? So, that's a vector from minus q to plus q. We usually write as d. That's how now we know that one. Dipole moment is equal to q into one of the charge into the displacement vector from negative to positive. Yeah, any question? Now, this is a physical dipole. To construct a perfect dipole or ideal, perfect or ideal or point dipole, what you have to do? Yeah, in case of this kind of only dipole, remember your monopole moment is zero. Dipole moment is the dominant term. At very large distance, your potential fast like 1 by r square from the origin. R is from the origin, okay? Be careful. Again, I am stressing on the fact r is from the origin, whatever we have in the multiple expansion, okay? So, potential fast of like 1 by r square, okay? So, for dipole, pure dipole. Is that okay? Because total charge is zero. Now, how to define perfect, ideal or point dipole? Point dipole means this d should be very small, am I right? If d is very small, what would happen? Your dipole moment is zero. If dipole moment is zero, that term, contributing term will also be zero, isn't it? So, that's why this perfect or ideal dipole, it is defined as d should be zero, but q should be infinity. Charge should be very high. So, that q into d, that's equal to p, equal to constant. Or I better say large, isn't it? It should be low. Is that okay? He is smiling. I'm multiplying infinity and zero, writing it as constant, isn't it? So, shall I say like that? Low and large, very low. Okay, a kind of hypothetical approximation. So, he calls that one as, wait a second, artificial limit. It tends to zero, it's very large. Then what would happen? This is constant. Then that becomes point dipole, obviously. Am I right? When d is very low. That is the approximation. That's the artificial limit. Okay, q tends to infinity, distance between them tends to zero. That becomes a perfect, ideal or point dipole. Yeah. So, again that sometimes when you look the configuration from very large distance, that will look like point dipole only, isn't it? When you look at this distribution from very large distance, you will not feel any net charge. Why? Net charge is zero, remember. There will be no 1 by r or what you call dependency. There will be 1 by r square dependency. It will fall off very rapidly. So, now due to that, look at here, you will feel this one as almost point dipole when you look at this one from very large distance actually, practically speaking. Is that okay? Now, how to add those dipole moments, am I right? After having this physical dipole idea, how to add dipole moment, am I right? Now, let me take one example where four charges which are situated in the corners of the square, okay, plus Q, minus Q, plus Q, minus Q. That dipole moment have got very strange properties, okay. Wait a second, let me just discuss, okay. Now look at here, minus Q to plus Q, suppose the distance is D again, okay, D and D, minus Q to plus Q, this is one dipole moment. Now these two charges are engaged in the definition of this dipole moment, again don't assume these two here, okay. So now again these two are remained here. So now minus Q to plus Q, define one more dipole moment, you can add them. Even though they are spatially apart, you can add them separately. Is that okay? You can add them separately. So now let me call this one as P1 vector, let me call this one as P2 vector. Is that okay? Obviously P1 vector, suppose if I take this one as Z cap, what is P1 vector? Q into D into, suppose let me take this, the distance is D, okay? D into Z cap, then P2 vector is equal to Q D into minus Z cap. When you add them, you will get null vector. In this kind of configuration, your dipole moment, net dipole moment is zero, and you can add like that. Okay, that is allowed. Let me discuss little more about this one. The dipole moment will follow vector addition. P is equal to P1 vector plus P2 vector. Is that okay? Now look at here, wait a second, while doing this one, be careful, don't draw four dipoles. Here to here, here to here, here to here, here to here, okay. Once you construct dipole using these two charge, these two are engaged here, so you have to construct dipole using only these two charge. Or you can use this and this, that's okay. Is that okay? This to this and this to this, then these two doesn't exist. You can do any way, any manner, it will be zero. Are you getting my idea? Speak out quickly. Yeah. Which one? No. You can. Yeah. So here you can't combine like this. You can't combine. These are minus Q minus Q. That's why. Again, as you said, either vertically or horizontally, it doesn't matter. Even you can rotate this one. It doesn't matter. Net dipole moment will be cancelled out in this configuration. Yeah. No, you can take that one. If you take these two as dipole, again, this is engaged over there. Don't take this one as dipole. Yeah. So again, you can do like that. That's what I said. No, they interact. They interact. Plus Q, minus Q, minus Q, plus Q. Once you have taken these two charges for dipole moment one, suppose let me take P1 vector, so then minus Q to plus Q, that is P2 vector, okay. Now don't take these two again, it's already defined using this one. Now these two are engaged in this definition, am I right? Now this will constitute one dipole, this will constitute one dipole. Once you define it like this, don't again draw this one. That's what I'm saying, either this one or this one, anyway net dipole moment is zero. Is it clear? Yeah, speak out. Speak up. We are not writing any interaction term. The field exists. We are not writing any interaction term here. If you are writing any electric field force or something, then you have to take all charges, remember. This configuration, can I say P1 and P2 are joined like this? I get my point. Or P1 and P2, they are joined like this. You had two independent dipoles. You are just making this configuration. Right? It's done. Suppose, yeah, let me argue like this. Suppose if you have P1, P2, P3, P4. Let me take P1, okay? P1, P2, P3, P4. Minus Q, plus Q, minus Q, plus q minus q plus q minus q plus q. If you add them, what would happen? What would happen? Everywhere zero charge. Are you getting my point? It's not happening like that, isn't it? Either you can just join these two like this, or you can join these two like this. That's why I'm saying, once you define dipole moment using these two charge, don't again take that one to define other dipole. Okay? So leave them and go for other one and define dipole moment and add them vectorially. Yeah. Yeah, they need not to be square. If since it was square, net dipole moment is zero. I have taken that one.
Can be rectangle.
Yeah, it can be rectangle. Yeah, then also zero, am I right? Then also zero. Look at here. Plus q, minus q, plus q, minus q. Yeah. Isn't it? This length is same as this length, or this length is same as this length. It will be zero. Okay. Now look at here, in this one total charge is zero, monopole moment is zero, net dipole moment is also zero, dipole term is also zero, but quadrupole moment is non zero. That you have to show actually, but remember, for this kind of configuration quadrupole moment appears, which is non zero. Now what is the potential which is proportional to in this kind of configuration? What is electric field proportional to? Is that okay? Yeah. Now let me go to next one. Can you do 3.29, 29th problem? And 3.30, 30th problem. That is the problem that I was talking about. Continuous charge distribution, and you need to find the dipole moment. So for continuous charge distribution, you need to integrate over r prime vector. That r prime vector should be written in terms of x cap, y cap, z cap. But that is again a spherical symmetry problem. You need to use both coordinate geometry. I mean, one is writing the r prime vector as x x cap, y y cap, z z cap. Again, you have to write x equal to r cos theta sin theta like that while integrating. Okay, so try to do that one. So you have to make use of total coordinate geometry. 30th problem, 29 and 30. Okay, do that one soon after the class. Okay, now again I'll extend the argument. Any question? So I'll again extend. Okay, please practice this one, because very simple but logical questions are asked in gate exam very frequently. Okay, yeah. Origin of coordinates in multiple expansion. Okay, so the next concept, that's also very important. Okay, that's also very important. Now we shall start discussing that one. First, let me choose the origin. Okay. Let me choose one point charge at this point plus q. There are no other charges. There are no other charges. Is that okay? Now, what is the potential at a distance r from the origin? Am I right? That is the question. Is that okay? What is the potential? Now, in this situation, look at here. Your italic r is equal to r. What was italic r? Source point to field point, but my source charge is at the origin. That's why italic r equal to this one. In this situation, my question is, what is total charge? Q. Is that okay? What is dipole moment? Q into displacement, or q into position vector of the charge, source charge. Am I right? That's zero vector. Zero. Dipole moment is zero. Is that okay? Dipole moment is zero. So what about quadrupole moment? It's very difficult. Very different. That's also zero actually. Is that okay? Quadrupole moment is also zero usually. Now look at here. Let me show how that quadrupole moment is also zero, even though I don't know the definition. Okay. Now look at here. What is the potential actually? 1/4 pi epsilon naught. Actual potential. What is this one? Q by italic r, isn't it? Q by italic r, potential at r. Now in this one, so that is equal to q by r. That's your monopole term. these two are equal in this case, am I right? So that's why in this case, one is monopole moment is non-zero, second one is dipole moment is zero. Okay, what is the how potential depends on R? 1 by R. And that is the exact answer here. Monopole moment term is the exact answer here. And R, if you take actual one, which contains only V mono plus 0 plus 0 and so on. Why? Because italic R equal to regular R. Is that okay? So monopole moment term is non-zero. That's why you got a potential proportional to 1 by R. 1 by that's the actual one. Now I can confidently say one is dipole moment is zero, dipole term is zero. I can confidently say after seeing these two are equal, rest of all terms are zero. Quadrupole moment is zero, everything else is zero. Only monopole moment exists here. Okay, let me take this one as example one. Okay, my example. Now let me take example two. So now what I do here is, this is my origin. I am going to place charge plus Q here. Is that okay? At a distance A from the origin. Solve the problem, okay? Soon after that, you will remember everything, all concepts. Potential, actual potential is Q by italic R. Am I right? It contains monopole, dipole, but after finding italic R equal to regular R. So when they are equal, am I right? There are no other terms which are adding up. Okay? Write down here itself. Write down here itself. 1 by 4 phi epsilon naught Q by R. That's equal to V mono. If actual potential is equal to monopole term, I mean the rest of all terms are 0. V dipole is 0. V quadrupole and so on like that. Everything else is 0 in this situation. In this situation. Suppose if they ask what is the dominant term, okay? Suppose if they ask what is the potential depends on how potential depends on R at very large distance, just observe whether this is 0 or non-zero. If it is non-zero, then obviously 1 by R term is the dominant one at very large R. You don't have to worry much. Okay? Wait a second. Now let me go to second example. Is that okay? Second example. Let me place plus Q charge here. Now what is the monopole moment? Q, total charge Q is monopole moment, non-zero. But you are finding potential at R at point P. Is that okay? Now what is the dipole moment term? Q into position vector of the location of the charge. Am I right? What is that one? A into z cap. A into z cap, look at here, dipole moment term is non-zero. Even though you have only one charge which is situated out of the origin, you got non-zero dipole moment. Is that okay? That is the basic definition of dipole moment. Now look at here, your dipole moment depends on the choice of the origin, am I right? If you move the origin, your dipole moment will change. Monopole moment will not change, it's independent of the origin always. Total charge is always independent of the origin, okay? And your dipole moment, in this case, it is depending on the choice of the origin. Wait a second, we need to extend this argument. Now look at here, now what would you say? At very large R, how potential depends on R, if I ask the question? What would you say? 1 by R, you have to talk about dominant term again, isn't it? You have to talk about dominant term. This is the dominant. Now look at here, in this case, I think all term exist, okay, in this case. So in this case, look at here, potential at R is equal to V mono or let me write like this. What is that one? 1 by 4 phi epsilon naught q by r. This r is the distance from the origin, remember. What was your actual potential, any idea? You have to take this italic r. What is the actual potential? 1 by 4 phi epsilon naught q by italic r, that is the actual potential. Now we are expanding this one. This is the monopole term. What is the dipole term? 1 by 4 phi epsilon naught p vector dot r cap by r square. So plus and so on. First two non-zero term that I am writing. Maybe quadrupole moment is also non-zero. But if they talk about at very large r, obviously you can neglect all higher r part. You can say this is the dominant. And one more observation you do in this example is dipole moment depends on the choice of the origin. Write down that. Write down clearly. Dipole moment depends on the choice of the origin. In this situation, okay? In this situation, don't again generalize the statement. Monopole moment will never depend on choice of the origin because monopole moment means total charge. Is that okay? Yeah. Next one, quickly. Let me take third example. I have two choice of origin. Okay, I have two choice of origin. I have plus Q charge, minus Q charge. Is that okay? Now let me write this one as those two vectors will be merged. Wait a second. Let me choose one more here. Okay. Charges are in space, plus Q and minus Q. Obviously, you know, it's a physical dipole, am I right? Let me take O1 and O2, okay? From O1, let me define dipole moment, okay? Dipole moment. What is this one? R prime 1 plus R prime 1 minus. Is that okay? Dipole moment with respect to O1, that's equal to plus Q into R prime 1 plus, 1 means with respect to first coordinate system, okay? So minus Q into R prime 1 minus, Q into R prime 1 plus minus R prime 1 minus, what is this one? R prime 1 plus minus R prime 1 minus, that's a vector from this one to this one. Q into D vector. Now, once you see this one, you have to say it should be independent of the choice of the origin, am I right? Vector in space is vector in space, whatever the choice of the origin, isn't it? Now, look at here, again, if you want to say that is independent of the choice of the origin, look at here. Let me write this one as R prime 2 plus, okay? Let me write this one as R prime 2 minus. So, from the second origin, what would happen? So, dipole moment with respect to O2, that's equal to Q into R prime 2 plus minus R prime 2 minus. R prime 2 plus minus R prime 2 minus, that's again vector from minus Q to plus Q. That's also Q into D vector. Do this vector algebra and conclude. Dipole moment is independent of the choice of the origin. Yeah. If you talk about dependency of potential at very large R, how it depends? 1 by? Speak out. 1 by R square. Why? Monopole moment is 0. Total charge is 0. Isn't it? So, total charge is 0. Q total is equal to 0. But dipole moment is non-zero. That's equal to Q into D vector. So, that's why V mono is equal to 0. V mono is equal to 0. V dipole is non-zero. That's why this is the dominant term at very large distance from the origin. So, potential falls off like 1 by R square. Yeah. Or you can take this idea. When you have only one charge, there will be net charge in that region. Potential falls like 1 by R. It's little slowly. So here you have both positive and negative charge. Net charge is 0. You have both positive and negative. They will cancel out. They will try to cancel out their effect at any point, isn't it? But those charges are not at the origin. They are not merged actually. Is that okay? They are separated, very well separated. They are not placed at the origin also. They are away from the origin. So that's why potential should fall, what you call, faster than this one, this situation. Isn't it? Because you have positive and negative effect at any point. So that also you can take that idea. Over. So next one, now we have to generalize one thing. Here, since total charge is, what is the difference between these two? Total charge is non-zero, total charge is 0. Am I right? The same argument you can do. So suppose if I have plus Q, minus Q. Again, you have a minus 2Q, plus 2Q, somewhere here. Again, you can do all of this. Again, net dipole moment will be independent of the choice of the origin. You can just do the same algebra. You can show that whenever there is net charge is 0, isn't it? Now, can I just draw one more dipole moment like this? Now, net dipole moment is addition of these two. It is independent of the choice of the origin. So write one statement, generalized statement. If total charge is zero, yeah, what he said? Yeah. If a total charge is 0, the dipole moment is independent of the choice of the origin. Now look at here, it's very strange, it will allow a lot of tricks here, okay? Suppose let me take one triangle. I think in gate exam they ask this kind of question. Minus Q, plus 2Q. What is the total charge? 0. Then you don't have to talk about origin. Is it okay? You don't have to ask which is the origin for finding the dipole moment. Now how do you find dipole moment? You can take origin anywhere and you can find. Still, it is independent of the origin. You don't have to choose origin. Isn't it? Then how do you find dipole moment? Yeah, so divide this one as plus Q. Okay? So, engage these two, club these two. Is that okay? You have one dipole moment like this, minus 2Q to plus Q, other dipole moment like this, find the vector addition. Is that okay? That's allowed. Or even if you choose origin somewhere, then also, just like this, it will be spatial vector. If you take position vector from some arbitrary origin, is that okay? So, because of plus Q and minus Q, again you will get those position vector only in space. Is that okay? So, whenever net charge is 0, you don't have to talk about origin, okay? So, that's why he has given in figure 3.34, he has given two configurations, okay? Suppose I have one situation and this one. Let me take this one as first one. Let me take this one as second one. Okay. If I have charges like this, minus Q, plus Q, plus Q. Now net charge is non-zero. Now if I ask what is the dipole moment, now you have to ask question. What is that one? Where is the origin? Why net charge is non-zero? So note it down. Note it down. We don't need origin here, but we need origin here to define dipole moment. Because you can't have that kind of spatial vector. You can just work it out, or take two different origin and work it out. You will not get different. Again, that is again generalization from single charge to two charge. For a single charge, what happened when you move the origin, your dipole moment change. Similar thing will happen here. Okay. Observe these things very carefully. A lot of questions designed. Now solve 32 problem. Yeah, this chapter is almost over. Okay, electric field of dipole should be discussed and some more problems from outside. Then within one day I have to finish electric fields in matter. Yeah, on Sunday we better take 3 sessions, okay? 2 hours on this Sunday, 3 sessions. Morning, afternoon and evening, that's better. Morning only 2 hours. Suppose 5:45 to, we shall take 5 minutes break in between, okay? 5:45 or 5:45 to 8 o'clock. Is that okay? 5:45 to 8 o'clock. Have something before coming to class, at least biscuits or something, okay? Then we shall afternoon either 12 to 2 or 2 to 4 evening, like that, okay? 2 to our 3 session on this Sunday. Again evening class, at evening 5:30 to 6 o'clock we shall solve couple of problem. From 6 o'clock let me start some concept, okay? Solve all of this problem. I think, I don't know whether he has mentioned any other problem in the outside of this chapter. Try problem number 3.34, okay, outside the chapter. Work out 30th problem, okay, using coordinate geometry. Think over it. 32 and 34. Try 34 also. Have you worked out problem of cylindrical symmetry? Potential depends only on the axial distance. Solve that differential equation, Laplace equation. Laplace equation in which potential depends only on the axial distance. Yes. Okay. I think that will be in terms of logarithm. Keep arbitrary constant as it is. I mean, unless you know the boundary condition, you can't solve it completely, any differential equation, isn't it? So when potential depends only on the radial distance, the spherical polar coordinate, solve the Laplace equation arbitrarily. Keep constant as it is. And in cylindrical coordinate, if potential depends only on the axial distance, I think that was the problem somewhere. That was the problem somewhere. You haven't seen? No, in the last chapter itself. Three point three, third chapter. Yeah, find the general solution to Laplace equation in spherical coordinate for the case where V depends only on R. So, and the same for cylindrical coordinate where V depends only on S. Okay, yeah, do that one.